What's it like to work on a cruise ship? Honestly, I don't think there's really any way that you could possibly understand what it's like to work on a cruise ship until you work on a cruise ship.
What do you think, Goon Rock? Are you ready? A little party that'll kill nobody.
What's your name and what do you do?
I'm Shaniqua and I'm a professional dancer.
Where are you from, Shaniqua?
I'm from your dreams, baby.
The next Queen of the Sea 2020.
Job, what my job entailed, everything that happened to me in the months before I got trapped in one cabin on a cruise ship for an entire month. Day 18 today. Starting with how I actually got the job. Around last year, February, March, my sister was talking about how she really, really wants to work on a cruise ship as a doctor because she would be able to travel the world and also work at the same time. Now look, this is something that I've wanted to do for my entire life. I got a little taster of it when I was working with Harley Davidson and I was making my YouTube videos and I was traveling on my motorbike across Europe. Then funnily enough, I was actually, just for fun, working on a film set as an extra. They were filming Doctor Who and I met this girl who was working for the company that I work for now as crew staff, as entertainment. She was pretty much just doing extras work for fun to fill the time while she was on holiday before starting her next contract. So I ended up taking her number because I thought she was a really nice person, and just in case I decided somewhere further along the line that I wanted to work on the cruise ships. Fast forward 1 month and I sent her a message asking her how she got her job, how I can apply, and pretty much what her job entails. I landed up applying online. It depends on what department you're going for, how the application works. It was like an automated interview and then you submit your answers. I had normal interview questions and then I also had to dance to a song and then I also had to sing a song, and at some point they were quizzing me on recognition of faces and names, because of course you work on a cruise ship, you're working with thousands of guests every single day, you have to at least remember who you've spoken to, who you know, you have to try and remember all of these guests' names, which I really I suck at that. Wow, me and names. Actually, funny story. One time I was hosting karaoke. I went up to go say, "Well done, Kathy. You sang beautifully. Thank you so much." Something along these lines. And luckily, the technician hadn't put my microphone on because the woman's name wasn't even Kathy. She whispered in my ear and she was like, "It's not Kathy, it's Sarah." And I was like, So luckily, this wonderful Sarah lady saved me from the embarrassment. Anyways, back to how I actually got this job. I submitted my online application, and about 1 month later, I was interviewed by this lady that was all the way from Italy, and she loved me, and pretty much I got the job that afternoon. Now, when you actually get the job, it doesn't mean that you actually have a contract. You kind of get put into like a pool where there's lots of people all looking for the same job that you have, just waiting for contracts to come through for them. I had requested that I could hopefully get a contract in the Caribbean, because I've always wanted to see the Caribbean, and then also the ship goes to Northern Europe, and I was like, wow, I'm gonna go to Northern Europe, I'm gonna see all these places, and I'm so excited. And then Corona happened, and I'm not going to Northern Europe, I'm just stuck in the Caribbean, so... Anyways, I had to complete a bunch of courses that make you eligible to work on a cruise ship, because you have to be able to actually help if something goes wrong. I know you have to do firefighting, you have to be able to jump off this really high bridge thing into this really cold pool, how to survive in the ocean if it's really, really cold and the ship is sinking. You know, you sometimes sit in these courses and you think, why am I doing this with my life? We only had one emergency where people were like, the ship's gonna sink at 4 a.m. in the morning, and the ship didn't sink, the ship was fine, but yeah. And for some people on board, when that happened, that was their first scary experience within 7 to 10 years of working on board. For me, it was within the first month. I've really been lucky with this contract, haven't I? And I landed up getting a contract that said that I would be embarking on MSC Meraviglia on the 5th of December 2019 in Cozumel, Mexico.
It's my new home. Hello.
And when I got here, I didn't have any idea what I would actually be doing in this job. I had been told that it was entertainment for adults, but beyond that, really, I had no clue what I would be getting myself into. In summary, this is how my job works. We work 7 days a week providing entertainment for adults, which is pretty much anyone that is 18 and over. Trivia, games, parties, dance classes. And then we also help out with random bits and bobs like embarkation and disembarkation. On the day when you come on board, you'll see us going, "Hi, welcome on board.
Hi, welcome on board. Hi, welcome on board."
A lot of people who want to come work on the cruise ships hope to travel while working on board. If you want to see a whole country, you're not going to be able to do that on board. But if you want to see the ports, if you're organized and have a lot of energy, you should be able to see a decent amount of stuff. Now, to the average person, this sounds like the dream. And to a certain extent, it is. But I'm going to be totally honest and say that I have never been more sleep deprived in my entire life. But to be honest, people in my department, in crew staff, you have to have a lot of energy. We are constantly carrying heavy things, dancing for hours on end, being happy. Trust me, being happy 7 days a week, all the time, if you're not naturally a smiley, happy person, you're really gonna struggle in this job because you literally are like, "Hi!
Hi!
But if you're not that kind of person, I'm sorry, you are gonna suffer in this job. Then you should rather be security. Speaking of security, when I first embarked on the 5th of December 2019, there was this very handsome man standing at what I like to call the scanny machine where you have to x-ray your baggage. I was so tired from traveling for 52 hours getting all the way to the ship that by the time I got there, I physically could not pick up this bag and put it onto this x-ray machine. And this sexy security came and picked my bag up and put it onto the x-ray machine for me. And I was like, but of course I acted very cool. You gotta be subtle. I mean, this is day one on board. Anyway, I had no plans of getting into any kind of relationship or getting involved with any kind of guy because people had warned me about ship life and guys. Honestly, that's what everyone said to me. For the first month that you're on board, don't get involved with anyone because you can't trust anyone. When I was back home, I was like, what are these people talking about? This sounds so dramatic. It is literally as dramatic as it sounds, if not worse. You have to be very careful with who you get involved with on the ship, but that is a whole nother topic. Because for me, it landed up that Mr. Security liked me, and we were just staring at each other for like an entire month until eventually, he messaged me on the 9th of January, and I landed up going to his cabin at like 2 a.m. in the morning on the 10th of January. And look, we both had different ideas of what was gonna happen on that night. For me, it was meant to be casual. He hates it if I use that word. For him, I think he thought he wanted casual, but he had way more of a crush on me than I realized. From that day, we have been together ever since.
What do I know?
Are you filming me?
No, what do I know?
Do you know Billie Eilish?
I heard about him.
Did you say him?
I don't know, but
it's her!
What about you? Have I heard about you?
Yes.
I can't sing this song now, I'm too embarrassed.
Oh, you're so cute.
Okay, I'll try. Ah, I can't do it.
That's beautiful.
How are you, friend? Nice to meet you, nice to see you. This is little Cassandra right here.
He's crazy.
Thinking she's so cute, but she is, so. Okay, that's it.
I just wanna know.
What do you wanna know?
If you're gonna stay.
I'm going.
I just gotta know.
Any other way,
I swear she's destined for the screen.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
To Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady,
my beautiful Cassandra, she's so beautiful.
That's the end.
Ah, you're amazing. Uh-huh. Now give me a kiss, now give me a kiss. Give a kiss for the camera. Now give me, now let's go.
And he disembarked on the 9th or so of February. And that was so sad. We both landed up realizing how badly we wanted to be together. And he asked me if I would like it if he came back to the ship for his next contract rather than going to a different ship. And of course, I said, yes, come to the ship, I'm so excited. He was going to embark on the 15th of March. We were counting down the days. We were so excited to see each other. And one day before he was meant to fly, they canceled his flight because of Corona. And so since then, he has been stuck at his home, and I've been stuck on the ship, and we have no idea when we are gonna see each other again. Which is actually really, 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 really sad. There's kind of nothing that we can do about it. And the thing is, we just got so unlucky, because if he had flown one day earlier, or if I had been disembarked one day earlier, we would have been next to each other right now. As he always says, it is what it is, and what can we do? So I know that when we see each other, it's gonna be amazing. If you're interested in the story, don't worry. We are planning on making a video that will be coming up to explain how it is that we actually landed up getting together and how we fell in love. As corny as that sounds. I love my job. I'm definitely going to be coming back for another contract. For now, as a 23-year-old, this is an amazing experience that I will be able to speak about for the rest of my life. I don't know when I'm going to get off the ship. I don't know when I'm going to get out of this room. Hopefully I don't lose my mind. But we're all in this together. So that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully it gave you some insight on what ship life is kind of like. And if you have any requests, feel free to write in the comments down below if there's any kind of video that you'd be interested in me making. Because trust me, I have time. Bye.
Keiji, how are you?
Meow.
Keiji, meow for us. Say meow.
Meow. For me to say you love.
But I do.
It's hard for me to say you